Good morning, Conversations with a Lunatic here. My name is Joselo, and in today's video, we're going to talk about why you need to stop trying to reinvent the wheel, stop trying to be unique, stop trying to be one of a kind, and just copy what works and get the ball rolling. Recently, I've gotten like a lot of like, not hate, but a lot of like criticism of how I might be like a copycat of one of my best friends and how I'm very, very like strategic in the way like I might copy people. And how that can come out as like a negative thing or a bad thing because, oh, I'm not unique or I'm not one of a kind or I'm not good at doing my own thing. But this is something I learned from Kevin Samuels, and that it's a kind of belief that I took with me and I applied it to every part of my life. And I'm gonna continue to do it because it works and it saves me a lot of time, and hopefully it's gonna save you a lot of time. So I really like Kevin Samuels. I enjoyed watching a lot of his videos. Rest in peace to him. And one of his videos, one of the pieces of advice that I truly did resonated with me and insight was, when he started YouTube and he started like his own business, he didn't spend hours and hours trying to think of a way to set up his website, set up his YouTube channel, set up whatever he was doing. All he did was go on YouTube, look up the most popular YouTuber, copy and paste his format, what he was doing, and then he just copied it up for his own and started doing it on his own and making up his own like company and his own business, but copied the format of the most popular person who was doing it at the time. And that blew my mind. He was like, I'm not gonna waste any time trying to think of a new description, think of a new way to make videos, think of a website. Like, he's not gonna waste any time. He just wanted to get straight into it, get started with the work, get the ball rolling. But the beginning part of thinking about, oh, how should I put this, how should I do this, how should I do that, that's what he like completely got rid of by just copying what already works instead of trying to reinvent the wheel. And this like completely resonated with me, and it's something I do with my best friend. My best friend is Patrick. I'll put a little picture of us when we were little right here. This is my best friend. We spend like every day together, work out together, party together, work together. We do everything together because we're brothers, and it's really important to have a brotherhood, really important to have like tight-knit people in your life. And I've known this person since I was in like kindergarten. I'm in sophomore in college now, so that's a long time being best friends, for like 14 years of our lives. Throughout our life, throughout my youth, like I always felt inferior to him. There's like a lot of like insecurities and like really deep down shit in our friendship. But I always felt inferior, and I always felt like he was so good at like almost everything than me. And I always felt like I was in a battle to like kind of top him and like catch up to what he was doing. And it still feels like that to this day, to like kind of set myself apart and be my own person and be at his level or surpass him and beat him in like whatever things we both like doing. Could be like the girls part of our life or the gym or now business. It's always like we're always trying to top each other, and that's a really good kind of friendship to have, because we're always trying to top each other, and it pushes us for both of us to be the best versions of ourselves all the time, because he does something new that tops like what we thought was possible. Then that makes me jealous and I want to beat him, so that makes me push myself to top him. And it's this constant like topping each other type of like friendship and brother friendship that makes us both better people, makes us both the better versions of ourselves. So if you don't have a brother in your life that you can do stuff like that, that you can push each other to that brink of like wanting to beat each other all the time, get that in your life. It's like very OP and it's very overpowered for self-improvement. I've copied him so much to the point where it's like I'm very honest about it now, and I started getting the idea for this video because of how blatant my copying and me just not caring about copying and just doing it, because I knew what he does works. It works so well because that guy knows how things work. His mind is just like smarter than mine or something. Like, he just catches on to things much more quickly than me. So to give you some examples of like what I've copied, he got earrings before I did. So he got earrings first. And it started working for him because he started like, people were like really liking it. People were saying he was attractive. He was getting way more girls just because like he looked more cooler like that. And I was like, interesting. Copied what worked. I got earrings. And then I got my earrings. Then I started being called more attractive, getting more attention, more attraction from girls. And then it worked. So I copied what worked. Face care stuff. He's always been on that I never got on the face care routine stuff, taking care of myself. It took me a long time to finally start it. Of course, recently I started like hammering that part of my life in, make sure keeping my face clean, making sure I take care of myself. Copied what he does, copied exactly his routine, copied it like blueprint by blueprint, and now it works, just copying what he does. The next more like obvious thing is the bandana. He started wearing bandanas before me, and he would wear them on dates, he would wear them just to work out, and he looked cool. He looked more masculine, he looked more, what's the word, just more, he just looked cooler and more masculine, and it worked. People thought he was attractive, he just looked more cooler. And I thought about it, I want to be more masculine, I want to look cooler, I want to look more, in general, it's like more masculine, I want to push for that, that's like what I want for my life. I went to the store and I bought a freaking bandana and I just put it on just to try it out, just to not reinvent the wheel, like what's something I can put on my head that's gonna make me look more masculine. No, like he's already doing it, it's working for him, just copy him and then see if it works for you. And then I did this and I love the bandana now. It's become a part of my own identity too. And I wear it on dates too. I like wearing it out to the gym too. And I like wearing it in general because it makes me feel more masculine and it's something cool. It's something cool that not a lot of people do. So this is to show you how I literally don't care. He's my best friend, so I don't care that I'm copying him. But even if he wasn't my best friend, even if he was just someone on the internet or just someone random, it doesn't matter because we feel like, oh, if I copy that person, oh, people are gonna know, people are gonna make fun of me, or people are gonna think like, oh, I'm not unique or whatever. If I ever meet someone and they see me the way I am now, like with the earrings and the bandana, they don't know that my best friend is Patrick. Like if they're a stranger, they don't know that my best friend is Patrick and he did this stuff before me and that I just kind of copied and pasted and made it my own thing after. They don't know that, so no one really cares and or knows. And people that do know our like relation to each other, they don't really care because no one really cares. Like life is too overcomplicated for someone to care. Like damn, those two, like they're literally replicas of each other, they just copy each other all the time. No one really thinks that or cares. So for you, in whatever situation you're at, because this can be applied to all areas of life, it's not just about attraction to girls, it's not just about copying your best friend, it's about copying in every area of life. If you're a newbie and you're new to something, if you're a beginner or you just don't have experience, and when you don't have experience in the beginning of any like task, any goal, any like life thing you're gonna do, you're always gonna be stuck in this like, oh, like I don't know what to do, what should I do, how do I start this, like how do I be like unique, how do I start off, like what's, don't overthink, just get started, get the ball rolling. And how do you do that? You look for someone that's already like kind of experienced, that already has the results you want, they already did what you want, they already like succeeded at the goal you want, and you just copy them. You just copy exactly what they're doing and you make it your own. And then that's gonna get you rolling, that's gonna get you experience. Once you have experience, once it starts, like it'll become something, like it'll become part of you, it will become something that is a part of you, and it'll be your own thing, and you'll be able to freestyle and make it like your own spin on it. Then you can make it a little unique to yourself. I literally, once I understood this concept, I applied it to my YouTube channel too. My description, if you check the description right there, I didn't like spend hours thinking of like, how do I set up the description like this, how do I put this hashtag, what do I do. All I did was I went to my favorite YouTuber that I already watch every single day, saw their description, I saw, oh, they have hashtags of their channel, their full name hashtag, and then some hashtags of what they care about, discipline and mental health. All right, I'm gonna just copy that. And I put it as my own. Oh, like the description, the format of the lines, and then sharing my Instagram and then putting this in there. Oh, that was another YouTuber did that. Let me just copy and paste it and put it on my own. So instead of sitting for hours waiting and wasting time thinking of like, how do I put this here? How do I do this here? How do I do this? Just go to the people that are already doing this, my favorite YouTubers, copy what they're doing, now make it my own. And now I can move on with my life and do the more harder things like making the video, getting experience, posting videos, editing. Those are the more important deep work tasks, more important parts of life. Instead of thinking of like, what do I wear? Do I get earrings? Do I get a nose ring? Do I do this? Do I do that? What do I do? Do I get a septum? Just copy what works and then make it your own over time. So you might feel imposter syndrome at first. You might feel like, oh, this feels weird. Or people are gonna make fun of me. Or like this feels like just in general, like I feel like imposter syndrome. And that's totally okay. You just have to fight through that feeling and just get experience with whatever you're doing over time. get as much experience as you can, get the ball rolling, and then over time, whatever you're copying, whatever doesn't feel like it's part of you, it will become a part of you. The bandana, since I've copied it for so long, it feels a part of me now. It feels like, okay, this is a thing that I like wearing now. It's cool. I think I look cool. It adds to my masculinity, and it just adds to that masculine look. Cool. The earrings, they're a part of me. I've worn them since October. They're a part of me now. I feel like they're a part of my personality for now, my character for now, my identity for now when I'm 20. And they're gonna stay there because now the earrings are a part of me. Yeah, I copied them at the beginning. It felt kind of weird to wear earrings. It was like the first time I ever did this. My best friend had earrings first, copied it from him. But now it's like a part of me. It's like my own thing now. And that's how this thing goes. So yeah, get over imposter syndrome, that weird feeling you have inside. It's gonna stay there, but over time it will fade once whatever you're copying becomes part of your identity and part of your personality and a part of your habits and everything. And then you'll be able to move on. I hope you guys enjoyed this short video. It had a quick message. Just stop overthinking. Stop trying to be unique. Stop trying to be one of a kind and thinking, and just get to action and getting the ball moving and getting experience in whatever aspect you're in. I don't know what aspect you're in. I know what aspect I'm in. Trying to build up my attraction, trying to build up my masculinity, trying to look more attractive. So instead of trying to figure out how to be more attractive, I can just copy what already attractive dudes are doing, like my best friend. What he's already doing, earrings, bandana, haircuts, taking care of my eyebrows. If he's doing that, just copy that. Copied it, now I'm considered attractive. And I didn't have to overthink about anything or waste time procrastinating. I didn't have to waste time doing that anymore just because copy what already works. Stop trying to reinvent the wheel. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I can see you in the next one, and check out my mental health video that I posted below. Comment down below like what's something you're thinking of copying now, something that you might like add on to your personality, add on to your identity, and you're gonna try to make it your own. Comment down below and let's have a little discussion.